So the real track, you know, probably the first G-funk sound and the most defining earliest version of a G-funk sound is actually Above the Law from an album called Vocally Pimpin'. The song is called Dose of the Megaflex. Now, I'm just gonna let a little bit of it ride out, and you can hear everything. You can hear the high-pitched synthesizers. You can hear the sound. You can hear Above the Law, classic G-funk West Coast group, you know, going off.
Yo, man, I heard you was having a couple of problems with your homes, Snow.
Yeah, man, some of them hold on you and they want to live, but just for your fucking money, man.
Well, you know, I got a little philosophy for shit like that.
What?
It's like if you pimp one home, you can pimp a thousand of them. Yo, but I'm gonna let KMG break it down for him like this.
Yes,
yo,
crazy.
Let's rent South Central. Here's a toast to the motherfucking bookie. Hoes with no clothes, get a woody from a G star. The hoes wanted them thick. You know, a groupie's best friend is some hell of a dick.
Highly recommend a lot of their records. All right, this is produced by Cold 187. You know, probably one of the pioneers, if not the real forefather of G-funk music in terms of production wise. He's kind of like, you know, paved the way for that, and really harnessed that sound. Now, you had other artists. Dre gets most of the credit for G-Funk, but you had other artists like Warren G, Snoop Dogg, and Nate Dogg, who are in a group called 213. Warren G is stepbrother, younger stepbrother of Dr. Dre, and he's the one who looped in Snoop and Nate Dogg with Dre. You know, and so Warren G actually had a lot of touches on a lot of the early records that Dre gets credit for. But anyways, that's Dose of the Megaflex, notable because it's one of the first G-Funk, you know, album, you know, songs to pop off, you know, early, you know, 91. So yeah, you should check out Cold 187. He's the nephew of Willie Hutch. Willie Hutch is a Motown era guitarist, heavily sampled, you know, great guitar, you know, funk soul guitar player. It's his nephew, is Cole 187. And Cole plays, you know, a bunch of instruments. He's a multi-instrumentalist, you know, plays 8 instruments. So he's more than just a sample beat maker type. He's like an actual music head. But yeah, like I said, he's often this uncredited pioneer of G-funk music. Most of the accolades go to Dre, again, because, you know, he had the, you know, Dose of the Megaflex. You know, it didn't really like, it didn't have the impact, you know, Vocally Pimpin' by Above the Law didn't have the impact that the Chronic and Doggy Style did on the masses, you know. And so because Dre, you know, obviously was part of both those records, you know, he gets that credit. And it's because he's the brand name that's associated with the genre. Now, Dre and Cole worked together on another early Above the Law album called Living Like Hustlers. So eventually he came in and he was one of the in-house producers at Death Row Records. So him and Dre have had these relationships, you know, in various capacities. But he's one of the people you want to know about, know who they are, know the influence that they have had is Cole 187. Probably, you know, the real true pioneer of the G-Funk style sound, and that Dre took and did his Dre, added his Dre touch to and blew it up to the world.